Hi friends, welcome to A for Achu. Today I'll be showing you a simple method how to crochet. I'm going to show you how to make chains as well as how to make single crochet. This video is going to be a very slow demonstration, so even an absolute beginner who doesn't know anything about crochet will be able to learn seeing the video. Let's go into the video. To begin crochet, you will need acrylic yarn. I've taken 100% acrylic yarn. This is available in any craft store near you. You will also need crochet hook. For easy understanding, I have used 4.5 millimeter hook. You'll also need a pair of scissors to finish your work. To begin crochet, you will need to make a slip knot. I'll show you how to make the slip knot. Take the yarn, the loose edge is here. Circle it around the index and the middle fingers. Now insert it in between, pull it out. This is a slip knot. Now make it smaller. I'll show you again how to make a slip knot. The loose end is near close to the index finger. Now make a circle between the index finger and the middle finger. Take the yarn around, pull it inside and make a knot. The loop is very big now. Now reduce the size of the loop and insert your crochet hook inside. Now make it a little bit tighter. Now the slip knot is ready. You can start your work now. This is the slip knot. This is the basic or the beginner stitch for making crochet. Now I'll show you how to hold the crochet hook. There are two methods to hold the crochet hook. One is the knife grip or the pencil grip. You can use whichever is convenient for you. I usually use the pencil grip. So this is how, just like how you hold a pencil, you will hold the crochet hook. Then I'll show you how to hold the yarn. You will circle it around your index finger. Then you will hold the crochet hook like a pencil. Take it under the yarn. Twist it, pull it through the slip knot. This is called a chain. Take the crochet hook under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside the chain. Take it under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside the chain. Now you have to make how much ever chains you require for the pattern. I'm making a small number for illustration purpose. Twist it, pull it inside the previous chain. Keep doing until you reach the desired number of chains. Make sure that all the chains are of equal tension. This will come automatically once you have enough practice. In the beginning, it might be irregular, but later on as you practice, you will get even chains. Now I will show you how to make single crochet. First leave the first chain, go to the next chain, insert the hook inside the chain, go under the yarn, circle, twist, bring it inside. Now there are two loops on the hook. Now again go under the yarn, make a twist, pull it inside both. Go to the next chain, insert your hook. Go under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside. Now there are two loops on the hook. Again go under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside both the loops. This is called single crochet. Go inside the stitch. Under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside. Now there are two loops on the hook. Again go under the yarn, twist it, pull it inside the two loops. Now we are going to the next stitch. Go inside this chain, under the yarn, twist, pull it inside. Again there are two loops on the hook. Under the yarn, twist, pull it inside both the loops. Like this you will continue until you reach the end of the chain. Make sure that all the stitches are of the same tension. That will come with practice. Initially the stitches might be irregular, but later on as you practice you will get uniform stitches. Keep the loops little bit loose so that the crochet hook can go easily on the yarn. Now we are coming to the end of the first line. You can see that this is single crochet, it's all uniform stitches. As you practice, you will get it like this. Now how will you turn your work? You will again at the end of the chain you will again make a chain, then turn your work around. Again you will go inside the chain, twist, pull the yarn inside. Now there are two loops, again twist, pull the yarn inside. There are two loops again, pull the yarn inside, both, insert it, twist, pull it inside, take the crochet hook under the yarn, twist, pull it inside both the loops. Keep doing the same until you come to the end of the line. You come to the end of the line. Now again make one more chain and turn your work around. Repeat the same process. Make sure that the tension in the wool is same throughout your work, because if you have different tensions on each stitch then the work will become irregular. Now you have come to the end of the work. Now make the chain a little bit bigger. Cut it using scissors. Now pull it inside like this and make a knot. Now you have to weave this loose end inside the work itself. Turn it upside down and using your crochet hook, go under the yarn and pull your loose ends inside. Cut the loose edges. Similarly, you do it on the other side. Make sure that you weave the yarn in the back side of your work. Cut the loose edge. Now I have weaved the edges. This is your finished work. You will notice that all the stitches are of uniform tension. This will make the work look regular and uniform. With practice you will be able to get this. Now I'll show you some of the things which I made using single crochet. This is a small mobile pouch. It has a loop here. It is used making single crochet. This is a small bag. You can keep your coins inside this. This is made using a different type of yarn which has some extensions like this. This is a multicolored yarn. I've made a muffler out of it. This is also using single crochet. It's long. You will see that the entire work is uniform. This is also made using single crochet. Thanks for watching. Please like, share and subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get instant notifications on your devices. See you again in the next video.